phenomenal. Different. He's just different. It's just not something that you see often. You know what I mean? A lot of he took over, man. 30 points in fourth quarter and overtime. That's sick. You know, and he's capable of doing that. And that was just an amazing game, man. He's an amazing ball player, and it's just a spectacle to watch.
Did it seem like he got stronger? I mean, he played 43 minutes tonight. Does 30 and fourth in overtime? Did it seem like he got stronger as the game went on?
Yeah, it seemed like he actually found a rhythm towards like the end of the game. It seemed like he was being a little bit more aggressive towards the basket. Yeah, I mean, just got back to his old self. Like, that's what he does, man. You know what I mean? He does this, man. It's different.
Kind of a momentum does it bring to beat a team like the Pelicans right now, who are they're playing really well. I know Coach Malone said that he was talking to Mark to get
No, they're a good team. Not with the additions, with them getting CJ, it makes them really dangerous putting that ball in CJ's hand as a point guard. They're a really good team. Now defensively, they're good. They're big. They're long. They're smart. Versatile. Brandon Ingram's a hell of a player too. And it was just a testament to our resiliency, really. We just kept fighting, kept fighting. We know what we're capable of, and we just put it all out on the line. And glad we got this win. Now just getting ready for tomorrow.
It looked like you and Brandon were going back and forth throughout the entire game, just very physical, matching up with them one-on-one. What's it like being in that situation, being on an island for you? We talked about it before, but just getting back on that island and trying to shut it back down a lot.
You just got to make it difficult for him. You know, he's so tall. He shoots the ball really well and handles the ball really well. You know, he's a really talented player, really skilled. You're not going to shut him down every single night. You know, you just got to make it difficult for him. Just be physical with him, try and take away some of his easy looks.
Aaron Malone told us that he told you when you play downhill attacking that you said you're quote unguardable. Did that register or did you know that? Does a reminder help? I mean, obviously you were playing downhill tonight.
I mean, I appreciate that, man. You know, him reminding me of that. And I was with my family today. We were talking over the game too. And I think that's kind of this game is a good blueprint, you know, going forward. Just being aggressive and really getting downhill and putting pressure on the defense and putting pressure on the referees to make a call. You know, really getting downhill. You know, he's talking about letting people off the hook with settling and the fadeaways. And, you know, I'm just going to look to continue to be aggressive, attack, and assert myself on the offensive end.
Can you take us through the sequence with travel and then coach getting kicked out?
Yeah, well, I didn't think it was a travel. You know, I thought it was awkward step, but I didn't think it was a travel. So it was just a crazy swing, you know, because it goes from being either and one or two free throws to what I thought wasn't the right call. To our coach getting kicked out, and then two technicals. So really, like an 8-point swing, and we lost our head coach. But you know, I told coach I got his fine, you know, I got his tech. Appreciate him going to bat for me. You know, we all came together. Dave Adelman did a great job as well. So kudos to DA, man. That was big time of him to step up and really assert himself in the game.
Can you describe what the post-game locker room was like with DA, I don't know, did Malone come in there to celebrate with you guys with Joker? Can you just take us into that in that scene?
Yeah, it was hyped. It was hyped. Water was flying around. We were cheering. We was excited, man. That was DA's first win as a head coach, I think. So we got the game ball, and there's just a lot to celebrate with this game.
Does it make, I don't know, Joker maybe even more special that after a game like that, he just kind of goes into the locker room and Malone said, you know, acts like nothing crazy happened. He just, you know, is calm.
We definitely had to give Jokic praise, man. You got to with a game like that. That's just a special, man. A special. So that can't go unnoticed. It doesn't go unnoticed. he will never be underappreciated around here.
But does it say something about him that he just brushes it off?
I mean, that's what he does, man. He's used to this. He's used to this, and he knows that we have bigger goals in mind. You know, there's more at stake. So he's been here before, and he'll be here again.
And Coach Malone told Nicole the MVP. Bones came in here and started chanting MVP. If he's not going to speak up for himself like this, do you feel like you guys kind of need to raise the noise on that issue?
This dude is incredible. No, I don't say that about a lot of people. I only say that about a handful of people. This dude is incredible, man. He's an MVP. And I believe that. And he's coming out night in, night out, just putting up ridiculous numbers, and we're winning. I mean, I don't know everybody that votes on it, but this guy got to be at the top of the list.
Does it make you laugh to a certain degree when you turn on national TV and they're talking about, like, who are a million games down and not enough about Jokic or not enough about what some of you guys are doing?
No. We're not worried about that. You know, we don't believe the hype. We don't buy into the hype, man. That's not us. So they'll see us when we need to be seen. I mean, for those who know, they know.
A couple quick ones on the Zoom. Go ahead, Ashley Neville.
Hey, Aaron, good to see you. A couple games ago, I saw Barton on the sidelines being really vocal with you. What's your relationship like with him, and how has he kind of motivated you to stay with it, maybe when you're not playing as well during some games?
That's my brother. You know? What a thrill, man. You don't get no bigger, man. That's my brother. He's one of my best friends. We understand each other. We see eye to eye on the court out there. We understand what we're going through, and he's just always encouraging me, and I'm encouraging him. You know, we need each other kind of just go back and forth and kind of offset some of that scoring that Yoke needs.
Jim Collins, go ahead.
Hi, Aaron. Congrats for the win from Cordoba, Argentina. Denver dominates the point in the paint all night long, and Grove, when Valenciunas left the game. What can you tell me about that?
I think nobody can really guard Yoke, you know? It was fouled out, next man up, and Yoke was doing the same thing. He was just being aggressive, attacking and taking advantage of the matchup.